Hi, my name is Chikin. You can call me CK. I am a...
If you like our contents, do support us by like and follow our Facebook page and Instagram account, or subscribe our YouTube channel.
Hi everyone, it is EP3 of Wedding Filmmaker Series. Okay, let's continue on the gear part. Light, audio, and supporting equipment. Shooting a wedding, you don't have that luxury to slowly set up a light. Every minute counts. They got the auspicious hour to follow, and you need time to do same day edit video too. So, what's best? It is obviously the nature daylight. In fact, that is not something you can't control. Choose a spot that's bright enough for gate crashing. Get the bride to sit near to the window. That's just some of the way to make full use of daylighting. But, in case you need a little light to make up, you can probably go for Aperture AL-M9. It is a super small size, lightweight light that you can mount on your camera. It is strong enough for you to light up whatever you need. Also, because it is so portable, you can even play around with that light, like sticking onto the wall or so. Next, audio. Obviously, video is not about the visual only. Sound is very important too. There are two devices that are equally important. One is an on-camera shotgun mic, another is wireless mic. For on-camera mic, I would recommend Rode Video Micro for a start. Super lightweight, capture clearer ambient sound than the built-in camera mic. So it is suitable for all occasions throughout the wedding. However, when you need clearer sound, for instance, when the bride and groom recite their vows during RRM, that is when a wireless mic comes in handy. Rode Wireless Go is purely the winner here. The smallest ever wireless mic that I had seen with built-in mics and more. You can easily just snap it on and start recording. For some filmmakers, they like to shoot the wedding by hand-holding the camera. It takes a lot of experience and precise muscle control to nail the shot. And you probably need a camera with in-body stabilization like the Sony A7 camera. For me, I felt the handheld kind of achieved the smoothness of the video that I want. So, there are three essential items that I personally die must have. First is the video monopod. This is my favorite. I can quickly move around from one spot to the other and get a stable shot with this. I can also play with different angle and different movement. Truthfully speaking, you can actually use it to shoot the whole wedding with slight compromise. For this, I've been using Manfrotto Video Monopod. No complaint. I heard people using some other cheaper brand, but I always heard about complaint like the movement is jerky also. Second is the slider. The slide shot is something that all other supporting equipment cannot replicate fully. It's perfect for a revealing shot or a decoration shot. You can use the slider shot to complement some of the scenes too. To this, I would recommend Eldercroft. It was the most innovative product I have seen throughout these years. Portable, lightweight, and most important, small in size, yet movement length is long. For instance, a 40cm long Eldercroft slider can actually create an 80cm movement length shot. Yet, the movement is super smooth. Third is a stabilizer. When we first started, steady game and the light is our only choice. It's actually very heavy and takes a lot of training to master it. We used to be watching this guy, Devin Supertrump, to learn how he played with Steadicam. However, things changes when DJI Ronin launched. Suddenly, all the different brands coming out with a smaller and more portable version, yet stronger algorithm to stabilize your camera. That pretty much ends the era of Steadicam within the wedding industry. For this, I opt for Ronin SE, a lightweight and powerful stabilizer. Just check out any of the Ronin SE review video. You'll find its endless possibilities to help you nailing that shot you want. Slider and stabilizer doesn't come cheap. So my suggestion is go with the monopod first, then get those when you have more money. Having said that, buying gear is a never-ending journey. As your team grows, you will need more gears to complement each other. You also start aiming higher quality production. Moreover, you get some new and more advanced equipment launched every now and then. Lenses and supporting equipment are most likely the stuff that you don't need to renew often. but for the rest of your items, you could probably aim to use it for 2 years and sell it to buy new and better gears. Alternatively, camera rental is another good option. With this strategy, you can maximize your cost efficiency and increase your productivity over time. And that is another story which I will talk about in a separate video. In the next video, I will talk about post-production. Stay tuned!